What we're seeing is an outbreak of it. We're seeing increased number of cases, and when it affects children less than 6 months of age, it can be quite severe. Normally, when older children get it, it's a very mild illness. It causes a rash, a fever. Kids are sick for a few days, but they're not severely sick, and they recover. It's a rite of childhood. When kids get it less than 6 months of age, especially less than 3 months of age, it can be quite severe. It can cause like a sepsis type syndrome that looks like an overwhelming bacterial infection. And it can even cause meningitis and inflammation of the brain, encephalitis, as well as affecting many other organs very severely. It can cause inflammation of the heart, causing myocarditis, inflammation of the liver, causing hepatitis, which can be quite severe. Inflammation of the lung, pneumonitis. These kids are often very sick in the ICU. If a child less than 6 months has fever and a rash, I mean, you should most certainly contact your healthcare provider because there's a variety of things that it could be, including parechovirus. And obviously, if your child is sick, so if they're lethargic, if they're not responding as usual, then that's a cause of concern also. The rash can have a variety of manifestations. It can have flat red macules, so these are just sort of red lesions. It can be raised into a small papule. And it can also have an interesting distribution, so it can be on the palms and the soles. And there's not that many rashes that are on the palms and the soles. Sometimes that's the only place that the rash is, or sometimes it's more nonspecific, so it's just generalized redness all over the body. It's very difficult to avoid. It's so commonly transmitted within the community. It is transmitted via the respiratory route, so being around somebody who's sick for even 1 to 2 weeks after they recover, they can still transmit it. And it's also in the stool, and this can be in the stool for 2 to 6 months after somebody recovers. So obviously, excellent hand washing is good, hand hygiene is good, but it's so common in the community that it's very difficult to avoid. Well, it can be treated mostly with supportive care by making sure children get enough fluids, that their blood pressure is maintained, and that they get enough oxygen in their blood. But we also give antibody therapy, IVIG, to try to decrease the concentration of the virus. Be aware that this virus is out there. It's been circulating at higher levels than normal because of changes in transmission due to the pandemic. And that if your child does have fever and a rash, especially if they're less than 6 months old, please contact your healthcare provider.